Good morning, Eagle Nation. Today is Wednesday. It's the 2nd of November. It is the 60th day of school. Please join me for a moment of silence. Thank you for that. And now, your morning announcements. My heart will go on and on too. That was a song dedication from Yair in Miss Kelly's class. Yair says, I would like to dedicate that song to you, Miss Kathy. He said, even though I am not with you every day, my heart will go on. Thank you for being who you are, Miss Kathy, and thank you, Yair, for that song dedication. What a great way to celebrate our school value of caring. Today, we've got a lot of things going on, but let's stand together for this morning's Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. And before you are seated, for those that like to join me on a daily basis, let's knock out 10. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Nice work. And if you're staying up on the goal to get to 3,000 for the month, like St. Jude's Children's Hospital is doing, you gotta do 30 a day. Or I'm sorry, 100 a day for 30 days. But you could do it. That was 10 right there. We continue today with a couple of things. One, I want to remind you that, if you didn't know, I should say, let you know, that our volleyball team played their hearts out last night, and we congratulate them for representing us proudly and for having a great season. They were defeated last night to Magnet, who advances to the final, but they did an exceptional job, and we are grateful to you, Ms. Romero, to you, Mr. Aviles, and to all of our players on the Emerson Eagles volleyball team. Great work, and it never feels good to lose, but use that as fuel to help fire you inside when the next opportunity comes for training, for practice, or the next sports league. We're proud of you just the same. Stay tuned. The boys football, the flag football team plays this Friday at Garfield School. You can come and see them then. Or if you'd like to see Mr. Aviles playing, he's playing in a staff and coaches game on Thursday. I'm sure if you are as well, Ms. Romero. But they have a staff game on Thursday. And also the All-Star game is on Thursday. So lots of things going to wrap up this sports season and looking ahead into November, December, or end of November and beginning of December, the soccer signups will come out soon. Soccer tryouts will come out soon. And we're looking for coaches. So I've already had one reply from a staff member. Ms. T has expressed interest in coaching soccer. But if you have not yet expressed interest, please email me, let me know. Students, if you have not yet done so, you'll get the opportunity to do so, but you'll also need to make sure that you have your sports physical. So please be looking ahead so you are prepared when the opportunity comes. It's an early release day. Teachers, we will all engage in the Letters Day 2 training at the end of the day today. Please be sure that you have the link. You look in your email for that. And that you also have your Volume 1 spiral-bound book at your side as we continue our training together. Now, I'd like to share with you something from a book called Apple, Skin to the Core. And As we continue to celebrate American Indian Heritage Month, I found this and several other books at the Burton Barr Library, and I'd like to share this one, and throughout the month I'd like to share some various writings with you from various authors and various ideas that come from our American Indians here in the state and beyond the state of Arizona. And I want to start by sharing with you this idea. This book is called Apple. And I learned just recently, I know that 7th and 8th grade you're studying metaphors, and everybody's working to put a metaphor into their writing contest for the month of November. Well, it turns out that apple is a metaphor. Notice the red skin here, and notice the white inside. That's on purpose. What I learned was this. The term apple is a slur in Native American communities across the country. It is someone supposedly red on the outside and white on the inside. That same concept arises also in other ethnicities and other another ethnicities and other heritages, because we come in a variety of shades of color with a variety of mixes of our backgrounds and makeups and families and places of origin. So even, for example, many who are of Asian background and Asian descent, such as my wife, whose family is Vietnamese, she was often referred to as a Twinkie growing up, because if you look at a Twinkie, it's yellow on the outside and white on the inside. And it's a really heartbreaking thing to consider, because oftentimes people who live between two spaces are considered to be not enough of this to be accepted fully on one side, and not enough of that to be fully accepted on the other. And they sort of live in a space in between. Perhaps you do too. I think all of us, though, can do a better job of not looking at one another as apples or Twinkies, but simply recognizing that we can make space for all and to allow people to bring their full selves into the classroom every day to be a part of the learning experience together. So, Look Forward to This by Eric Gansworth. I'll share more writings with you as the month progresses, but that is your metaphor for today, apple. All right, now I'd like to continue with an introduction. We have a new staff member joining us today before we get to your words of wisdom. And so I would like to introduce Ms. Daniela Hernandez. Ms. Hernandez is a master teacher who's joining us here at Emerson. And so if you see her on campus today, she is here to help. She is a teacher, and she will help be building teacher capacity and also be working with many of you students directly. Would you like to say anything this morning on your first day?
Hi, good morning everyone. I'm excited to be here and to be working with all students and teachers.
All right, thank you, Ms. Hernandez. And now, your words of wisdom so you can get to the business of teaching and learning. Today is on the topic of friends. I think Yair did a nice job of setting us up. In Germany, they say this: a life without friends is a life without sun. Life would seem pretty gloomy without a friend, so think about that. A friend can lighten things up with a little bit of laughter. A friend can brighten your day with something as simple as a smile, and a friend can help you figure out ways to solve a problem. Cicero was an ancient Roman philosopher who said it another way. He said, "What sweetness is left in life if you take away friendship? It is like robbing the world of the sun." So today, thank your friend for adding a little sunshine to your life. With something to think about, this is Mr. Lodato. Continue to mask up as needed throughout the day. Make sure you use hand sanitizer. Then stay in your zones, put away your phones, and make it a great day or not. The choice is yours.